The dictionary class of C# has a major issue, and that is exactly what we are going to explore in today's video. First, in this video, we are going to explore what exactly the issue is, and then next, I'm going to show a workaround for that issue, and then finally, I'm going to show the appropriate solution of this issue and what we can do about it. So, for the purpose of this video, I created a class called User Manager, which is going to hold the dictionary. The User Manager class has a private read-only variable called _user, which is nothing but a dictionary, and the key for the dictionary type is string, and the type of value is a user object. User object is nothing but a simple C# class, which is a user model. It has few properties. For the purpose of this demonstration, we're just going to use the name and age property, though the user object is not that critical here. The most important thing is understanding what the issue with dictionary is. Next, the user manager class has a couple of methods. The first method is addUser, which takes an user object, and inside this method, what this addUser does is it adds the user object as a value to the dictionary. And for the key, it uses the name of the user. And then finally, it has a method called getUser. The getUser method takes a key, which is nothing but the name of the user. And based on that key, it returns an user object back from the dictionary. That's all we have so far. And then in the program class, what I have done is I just created an object of the user manager, but I have not used it yet. And then I created a list of user object, and inside a for loop for 10 count, I am adding 10 user object into this user list. So that's all I have done so far. Now we are going to use the user manager to add the user. Now what we are going to do is, instead of adding users serially, we are going to add the users in parallel. And for that purpose, we are going to use parallel.for. And here, inside of parallel.for, we are starting from zero. We are going through the count of user. And then for each index, we are going to do users. We are going to here, instead of doing this, which showed up automatically, we are going to use user manager dot add user. And for the user, we are going to pass users with the index. So we are going to add one user at a time. And here, after we add the user, I'm also going to get the user. And for that also, I'm just going to go ahead and use parallel.for. And this time I'm going to just print the name of the user. So I can do, go to the next line, I can do console.WriteLine. And here I can say user manager.getUser. And in this case, I'm going to use I can print the age here, which is also something we are adding. And then close. And that's about it. So now let me run this application. And if you see an error here, it says key not found exception, user-1. Now let me run again. See, this time it just worked and it printed out all the key. Let's make it right line. Now let's run again. This time it worked again. Again it failed. So as you can see, it is behaving very inconsistently. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't work. The part of the reason is because the dictionary is not thread safe inherently. Let me run again. And this time it is failing in another location. It is failing during the ad user itself. So as you can see, at times it works, at times it just fails. And the behavior is very inconsistent. So let's solve this problem. And as you can understand, the reason for this issue is nothing but we are trying to access this dictionary object in a multi-thread. And that is the major issue with dictionary, that it is not thread safe. So let's go with the traditional way of solving this problem, which is going to solve this problem and it is going to work consistently without throwing an error. So let's create a private read-only object underscore lock. And here we can say lock, and we can provide the underscore lock. And we can create a lock around the ad. And once we create a lock around ad, what will happen is all the ad will be locked. So only one thread can enter this block at a time. And then it will go to the get user. So this will ensure that we're not going to have any issue while running this, and there is no inconsistent behavior. So let's keep running this. Now we can see 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, it's sprinting till 9. Let's run a couple of times just to make sure that it indeed has solved our problem. And this is running again. So you can see it's running every single time and without any issue. Now what we are going to do is, instead of using the lock statement ourselves, we are going to use an out-of-box collection which is going to take care of this problem. So I'm going to get rid of the lock statement first, and here as well. And the next what I'm going to use is, instead of using dictionary, I'm going to use concurrent dictionary. And concurrent dictionary is part of system.collections.concurrent namespace. And I'm going to add that namespace. And once we use the concurrent dictionary internally does the exact same thing what we did before. That means it creates a lock around the add method. And this is the source code of concurrent dictionary. It has a try add internal method, which is an internal method. And this method, what it does is, if you look into the method, here it acquires a lock. It does a monitor.enter, which is same as lock statement. Lock statement is nothing but try monitor.enter, finally monitor.exist. So this is what it is doing. Inside of try, it is acquiring a lock using monitor.enter. And then in the end, in a final statement, it is doing monitor.exit. So we are doing exactly the same thing. So we were achieving what concurrent dictionary does, but concurrent dictionary gives this feature out of box. So we're just going to use this. Now there are a couple of things I wanted to show about concurrent dictionary. First of all, concurrent dictionary constructor has multiple overload. Now one of the overload which takes the concurrency level and capacity, and this is pretty interesting. Capacity is nothing but what is the initial capacity of a dictionary. Concurrency level is the estimated number of threads that will update the concurrent dictionary concurrently. And this number can be derived based on the number of CPU. So if there are two CPU, this number can be 2. Or you can give a higher number, a multiplier of that, for the virtual thread count. And based on the concurrency level, the higher the concurrency level is, the harder it is, or the time consuming it is for the concurrent dictionary to dynamically change the allocated number of items it can consume. So this is something to keep in mind. So now we have this concurrent dictionary, and now I'm going to keep the iDictionary as an interface for the time being. And if we run the application, we will see the exact same behavior as we saw before. That is, consistently, it is going to work without any failure. So it worked the first time. Let's run again, and I'm going to run a couple of times just to ensure and show you that we do not see the inconsistent behavior, and every single time it is working as expected, and we see that. Now, instead of using the iDictionary here, if we just use the concurrent dictionary class, concurrent dictionary do not define a contract for add. Instead, it defines a contract called triad, which returns a boolean. And if we use the triad, we are going to see the exact same behavior. It's just that it's going to return a true if the add was successful, and it will return a false if the key already exists, which works for most of the scenarios. But if you don't want to use the triad, you can also use add or update. And app.update takes another parameter, a third parameter, which is nothing but a delegate function, which takes the key and the value as the input parameter and returns the value as an output. Now here there's an opportunity to manipulate the value, but in our case, if we take, for example, the name and user as an input, we can just return the user back because we don't want to do any manipulation. And we can run the application right now, and we should see the exact same behavior as before, and it should work consistently irrespective of how many times we run the application. Let me run a couple more times just to make sure that it works as expected. And as you can see, it is consistently working as expected. So that is what I wanted to cover as a part of today's video. The one disadvantage with dictionary and how that disadvantage can be easily resolved just by using a concurrent dictionary class. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. If you are new to my channel and you think you are getting value out of my channel, please subscribe to my channel. And thanks so much for watching this video.